warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we'll talk about another episode of Al-Hilmiya Days, and they call it the shivering. When I talk about shivering, I remember a story happened to one of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. His name was Sa'id ibn Amr. Sa'id ibn Amr was a young man, was not a Muslim, on the fourth year of Hijrah, when he saw a prisoner of war was sold in the market and bought by some of the non-Muslim Qurayshite in Mecca, and they were torturing him, and they were insulting him, and they were actually in a very inhumane way treating him as a prisoner. I think he was not a prisoner of war. He was captured by a tribe while they were actually teaching Quran to some Muslims in one of the areas, and sold in the slave market, then in Mecca. Then one of the people who his father died or killed by Khubayb in the battlefield of Badr, yani bought him and was torturing him. So Sa'id ibn Amr was very astonished and surprised of the brutality of treating this human being, which was called Khubayb ibn Adi. And he looked at him very steady, very composed, very safe in his heart and in his mind and his soul, against this kind of atrocity and this kind of brutality being done to him. So he was killed, brutally killed by the people there, and Sa'id ibn Amr could not be able to remember how brutally he was killed, this young man. Then later on, Sa'id ibn Amr became a Muslim and was appointed by Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu as the Amir of Hims. Hims is in Syria, and he was a very pious man. So Umar received a complaint from the people in Hims for complaint about against Sa'id ibn Amr. The first one, he always come late in the morning. Second complaint, he always does not mix with us in the evening, at night. Third one day a week, he does not come out to be with us publicly. Fourth complaint, whenever he is with us, he go to this shivering and fell down. So the complaint went to Umar, and Umar brought Sa'id ibn Amr to investigate the situation. And Sa'id ibn Amr radiallahu anhu told Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu, if they have complained to me about this, let me tell you what I was doing. I come out late in the morning because I helped my wife in the house, cleaning, preparing the food and others. I don't come at night because I do my night, I make my night for Allah, to make Qiyam al-Layl. I don't come one day a week because I only have one dress to wear. So I wash it and I wait till it becomes dry. I don't have a servant at home, I help my wife, I only have one piece of clothes. Number four is this shivering, because whenever I remember how I failed Khubayb ibn Adi in Mecca when they were brutally torturing him and killing him, I become affected by the scene of the brutality being done against him, and I could not be able to realize how I failed to support Khubayb ibn Adi at that time. From this moral story, we go to the three shivering which hits me as well. First shivering was I was young in Hilmiya. Some people do some mistakes. Whenever I remember these mistakes, I feel that this shivering coming to me. That means that's a sign of repentance. Alhamdulillah. The second one, in our area, there was behind our house, there was a small avenue or cul-de-sac, as you call it. And in this cul-de-sac, there was a man who was actually not physically well, sick, could hardly walk, in the late 40s or early, I think late 40s, and he married to a younger woman who was very beautiful, and this younger woman started to have an affair with somebody else behind the back of her husband because he could not be able to perform his matrimonial relationship with her. One morning, we woke up on a scream and crying and shouting, and I found this man coming out, running from his flat, and with the fire coming from his head and his clothes, and it seemed that his wife threw some kerosene on him, tried to kill him, and to allow herself to run out, to go out with her boyfriend. And I did nothing to him because I was young, but when I remember this kind of scene of this burning man, I also be affected by Sa'id ibn Amir shivering when he failed to support Mawla Sayyidina Khubayb ibn Adi. The third shivering, which was more difficult for me, in Cairo at that time, there was a second school called Khidawiyya, which is one of the second school in Cairo for boys. And there's a big football ground, and used to go there to see the football league between the school, different schools in the area. After finishing this, I was walking out and going home, and I was just standing on the road, seeing a young kid about the age of 5 or 6 playing in front of his grandfather's shop, and this 40-foot container full of furniture was reversing back, and the driver could not be able to see who was behind him. And within seconds, this young boy actually was underneath the wheels of the rear wheels of the 40-foot container. And what I only observed is what's left over of his body, which is the shoes and the ankle of his leg. And this put me on the same feeling that Sayyidina Amr was actually having of failing to support Sayyidina Khubayb ibn Adi in Mecca, because I failed also to support this young kid from being killed by mistake by the driver of the container. So this will take us to a direction. Actually, if you repent, you have to feel it coming from your heart. Repentance is not about wording, it's about feeling of the burden of the responsibility of having the repentance before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or failing to support other people. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.